Okay, let us begin. Welcome to Superior Profit Weekly Market Roundup, 4th March 2017. I am Sagar Nandi, Chief Analyst and Trader of Superior Profit, a company registered in Singapore. Before we begin, let us go through the standard disclaimer. This demonstration is for educational purposes only. It is designed to share information on Superior Profit's trading system. The information presented here should only be used by people who are aware of the risk inherent in trading. Past performance is no guarantee of future return. Superior Profit is not an investment advisor. This is not a recommendation for buying or selling stock or any other instrument. Superior Profit will have no liability for any investment decision made by its audience. As usual, we'll go through key technical analysis of key markets, including oil, gold, few global indices and forex charts. We will look at SPY, QQQ and DIA through technical analysis. Then we will go into broad market, sector and industry analysis. After that, we will review few trades posted in community since last class, and we may look into potential trades for upcoming week. And if you have identified any chart, we can go through that jointly. There is no miscellaneous topic in this week. Q&A is all throughout the session. You may ask questions through the Q&A panel. I will keep an eye on it. I have a second monitor and I will try to answer the questions as we go along. As usual, let us make it interactive. I will also sometimes ask questions and you may answer through the same Q&A panel. Let's now go to MetaStock and go through the usual markets that we look at. Let me open the chart of US oil. Those of you who are attending our weekly roundup regularly, they know that for quite some time now, we have a sidewise view on US oil. Here we are looking at USO, the oil ETF. On the left hand side is the weekly chart with backdrop template, and we can clearly see that it is going sideways for a while. At the same time, the S&P 500 itself is going up gradually, that is causing the weekly relative performance to tilt down, showing that it is weaker than broad market. In the daily chart, as is going on for several weeks now, it is jumping up and down with gap ups at open, gap ups or gap downs, and that same trend continues. Interestingly, if we look at oil related news, there are several news in the media over last couple of weeks. However, even if we didn't care for the news, simply looking at the oil movement in daily chart, we see that it is going sideways. All the news that is going on in oil is not able to move it outside its narrow range. This is not the good time to trade directional trades and in oil, the same view that we have continued from last few weeks. Let's look at gold. We will look at the gold ETF. We have a bullish call on gold since almost the very bottom we could capture it. In a recent period, it is going somewhat sideways. There was a bullish headwind signal on 9th February. Then gold tried to go above that level, showed a bear release and came down. However, we are continuing with the long-term bull call on gold. When will we end the long call on gold? we can look at the hop off template. We could capture the bottom of the gold as of this day, 29th December 2016. Then in hop up chart, as it continued to go up on a long term basis, we were shifting the stop to the swing low. So currently we have the view that if this level, which is at this cube protection level, is broken around 116, then we will cancel the gold long outlook. So far we are maintaining it. On Friday, you can see on the last candle, gold tried to go down but closed up right at the white direction line, which is the very slow direction line. The same thing happened on Wednesday. It opened with a reasonable gap down, but it recovered almost all of the down move. We will see on Monday whether it goes down or goes up. If it goes down, then our long view on gold will be cancelled. So that was an analysis of oil and gold. We tend to look at Sing Dollar and India Nifty Index. Let's do that now. In one of the earlier classes, as of this day, that is 16th February, we had a bearish call on Sing Dollar, a swing short trade. As of that day, all the checklist conditions for go with flow short trade were satisfied. Stop would have been just above this high, and initial target could be once the risk distance is covered, which would be at the watermark low level, or the next support, which is the ascending slow direction line. It touched both of those prices. So as a swing trader, we would book profit either fully or partially. If partially, then we could put stop to make sure that the entire trade is risk-free as of now. Let's look at Nifty now, the global index that we regularly track. We will look at the Nifty futures. Because for India, Nifty itself is the benchmark, I will remove the relative performance line. Our optimal last entry point, very high profit entry point, was this bull release day on 27th December 2016, which was following very high activity at a watermark level. That would be a box long trade. Since then, it has been going up. In last couple of weeks, we have been watching it, and there was a watermark level at this price level, and there was also a memory line which is broken now. We were watching it thinking that if it goes above around this price level, around 9,000 or so, and then tilts down, then we may have a low risk short entry opportunity, either a bounce or a box trade. That didn't happen, though the headwind signal had come in terms of this magenta diamond. The headwind trade setup was not confirmed because all the checklist conditions of headwind trade setup were not met. Namely, the weekly was not aligned with the trade. On top of that, there were, when this headwind appeared, there were actually two support memory lines. One of them is broken now, but one support memory is still there. So if a memory support is so close when the headwind signal appeared, we wouldn't take a short trade. Whether it is a headwind trade or any other trade, if a memory line is close by, we tend to avoid taking the trade because the memory lines act as very robust support and resistance lines. As of the right edge, there is no valid trade setup. it is not extended on the upside anymore. You can see the stretch signal, the green dots that were appearing for several days. It is not appearing on top of the last candle. So not stretched anymore. However, there is no valid trade setup yet. We may continue to watch it and see if it tries to go up to around 9,000 again and tilts down. If that breaks the memory, then we could have a box trade, stretch release trade, or sideways market trade at that point. Now let's move to the US market. We will look at the three broad market ETFs, SPY, QQQ, and DIA. SPY continues to be strong. Interestingly, on Thursday, there was a headwind signal in SPY, and I think the signal had come on DIA and QQQ also. However, again, just like in case of Nifty in India, there was an support line, so there would not be any valid headwind setup for that reason. We still have no short opportunity. It's already overextended on the upside for quite a long time. It crossed upper boundary on 10th February, and now we are on 4th March. So it is overextended for quite some time. We would not like to take any long swing opportunity here. So we will wait for either price to pull back to value area and give us a long signal somewhere around 234, 235, or we'll look for a short signal, but there is none yet. Okay, we are with the at a glance view of DIA. This is also overstretched in the daily chart for many days now. And as I mentioned, there was a bearish headwind signal in the daily chart on Thursday at pendulum high. However, there was no trade setup. On Thursday, on Wednesday, incidentally, all the three ETFs went up with extreme or very high activity. You can see here in DIA, it was there in SPY, and it was there in QQQ also. Let's have a look at QQQ. Sometimes such very or extreme high activity at the top may point to exhaustion. That's why we keep an eye on that. And as you can see, it had appeared in QQQ also. And the bearish headwind signal was there in QQQ as well. So all the three ETFs, broad market ETFs, had gone up with very or extreme high activity on Wednesday and Thursday. All of them came down on a daily candle basis, came down strongly on a daily candle basis only. It came down strongly and all three had a bearish headwind. However, there was no trade signal in any of them, neither on the short side or long side. So that was our look at Sing Dollar, Nifty Index, and the three broad market ETFs, plus US oil and gold. Let's now look at some of the charts or graphs, rather graphs related to sector and industry analysis. Okay, before going into sector and industry analysis, let's look at the broad market internal. And I will now use my annotation tool. Since quite a few weeks now, we have been talking about the internals being weak relative to the broad market indices. NASDAQ Composite Index on the left hand side, NYSE Index on the right hand side, both using weekly chart. The indices are going up strongly, and now for 6th week in a row, it is overstretched on the upside for both NYSE and NASDAQ. That's quite a long period of time. So the indices continue to be strongly bullish. Last week, both of them made another all-time high, as you can see in these two charts, on the candle charts. However, as in last several weeks, the internals couldn't make new high. All of them are sloping downward, except probably this one to some extent. NASDAQ advanced decline made a high, which is almost close to the high of the last peak of the broad market index, of the NASDAQ index. So other than the advanced decline stocks, the number of advancing stocks minus number of declining stocks in NASDAQ, all the other internals are sloping downward since the last peak was made in the broad market indices. So the internals continue to be weak. However, the indices are strongly going up. So we are watching it. It is showing that though the internals are weak, relatively weak for a long time, indices can continue to go up for a long time. They don't immediately revert following the internals. Last week specifically, the new high low declined again in both of them relative to the week before that. Though the broad market indices both went up, the new high low in both of them declined. The up-down volume in NASDAQ actually declined and turned negative. Advanced decline in NASDAQ is still negative, though it slightly went up relative to last week. We can see here, slightly went up, but it is still remaining negative. And the up-down volume in NYSE went up slightly. It is very close to zero level. New high low, sorry, advanced decline also went up slightly. It is very close to zero level as well, with a reading of 55, where the maximum could be around 2000. Okay, Nigel has a question. Will the market eventually come down if the internals are weak? That is the usual observation. However, in current market, it is not going down easily. It's not going down. In the past, if internals were weak like that, relative to the indices for so long time, it would have at least a partial pullback. But in current market condition, it is not showing any sign of pullback, neither in NASDAQ nor in NYSE. Finally, to make money from trading, we have to follow the price move, not of the broad market, but maybe the ETF or the stocks. But we keep an eye on this broad market internal to see what is going on inside the market. How it can be useful? It is more useful for long-term investors. So if I am also buying stocks for long-term holding, when the broad market indices, both NASDAQ and NYSE are showing record highs, whereas the internals keep on showing weakness, that is usually not the time I will keep on buying new and new stocks. Unless if it is in an industry group that was moving opposite to the broad market. For the usual stock that follow broad market, this will not be a good time to buy long-term stocks. However, for swing trading, those opportunities will always be there. We'll now move to some of the graphs on sector industry, and in this case, starting with Dow Jones Industrial Average. This is a snapshot of Dow Jones Industrial Average sector-wise performance breakup as of Friday. On Friday, the markets did not change much, and the sector performance of DJI components reflects the same mixed picture. Half of the pie is green and half of the pie is red. On Friday, financials were the best performer, but you can see it didn't change much actually. The broad market didn't change much. Now, if we look at all the sectors for the period of last 1 week, we see that other than basic materials, all the sectors are up for the week. Only basic material switched from positive to negative. Positive to the right side of the vertical line, negative readings are on the left side of the vertical line. The red bar indicates value for last 5 days, blue line value for 5 days before that, and the green line another 10 days prior to the blue bar. So in the three review period, it was bullish in two of them, but in last week basic material turned negative. You see none of the red bars are on the left side, so all the other sectors ended in the positive. Financials, industrial and healthcare, these are the three sectors that flipped from negative to positive performance. So financial had a negative performance last week, it turned positive. Same is true for industrial and is true for healthcare as well. And energy as a sector is showing strength for all the three review periods, that is 5 days, another 5 days before that, another 10 days before that. Energy is consistently strong as a sector. However, we saw that it is not reflected in oil. So oil as a commodity is not so strong, but there are companies in energy sectors that are showing signs of strength. So they always do not have to go hand in hand. We finally have to trade looking at the particular instrument that we are trading and not just rely on oil as the underlying commodity to trade a particular stock. If we move now to the industry graphs, the last 5 days best performing industries, out of the top 10, two are oil related and two are housing related. Housing related industries that showed good performance were home improvement retailers and home construction. And the energy related to industry groups will be pipelines and integrated oil and gas. So one may look for swing trading opportunities in them. That is the top down approach, provided the Q charts and the Q trade checklist conditions are met. If we look at the 5 days worst performing industries, now we can see the flip-flop pattern of industry group is back again, showing that there is no clear conviction in the market on certain industries, including renewable energy, electronic office equipment, farming, fishing, etc. The three that are pointed by arrows. Renewable energy in terms of industry ranking was worst performing or almost the worst performing for many months. It showed sign of improvement for a while. So I was thinking we may have some long-term buy opportunities in this industry group. However, they weakened again. And the same flip-flop is seen in several other industry groups, including electronic office equipment, farming and fishing. It will also be clear from the ranking chart that this flip-flop is happening. Industries with biggest rank improvement, here five of the top 10 rank improving industries are in energy and mining. As we saw in case of sector, energy sector as a whole is showing sign of strength. The same is reflected in industry group as well. So we have oil and gas industry, oil and gas producers. These are the two showing sign of strength in industries, and industrial metal, iron, steel and aluminium are sign of strength. So metal and mining and energy related companies, five of them are among the top test rank improving industry groups. We can see aluminium had a huge rank improvement coming from more than 120, almost 130 to almost 2 or 3. We will check in the ranking table later on. So we can look for long opportunities in aluminium. Sometimes if the stocks are already overbought or if there is no valid Q trade setup, then one may take a day trade. That is for people who are willing to today take day trade. We shouldn't take day trade just because the industry group is showing sign of strength and swing trade is not available. But if somebody usually takes day trade as well as swing trade, in that case, if aluminium is showing sign of strength but no valid swing setup is there, one may look for a day trade in aluminium related companies. The same is true for iron and steel and the other industry groups which showed this kind of ranking improvement. In terms of industries with biggest rank declines, it is interesting again, there are lots of flip-flops visible here as well. Three rates were among worst rank decliners. However, I think just last week, if you are following this every week, you will notice that just last week, they were one of the best performers. These rates, specialty rates, real estate investment trust, residential rates, some of them were best performer, but now they have become worst rank decliners. Also, the flip-flop is visible clearly in utility and telecom related industries. In one of the earlier classes, we mentioned that these industries were gaining strength and they all belong to conservative industry groups. Utility, telecom, their revenue is more stable whether the market goes up or down. And we noticed earlier, I don't remember last week or the week before that, that these conservative groups were getting strength. But you can see so many of them, electricity, conventional electricity, utilities, fixed line telecom, gas distribution, and telecom. Six out of the biggest rank decliners, 10 biggest rank decliners, comes to these conservative industry groups. So this is again showing there is no real conviction in the market. Sometimes conservative stocks or industry groups are going up and then again they are going down. Sometimes aggressive stocks like financial or technologies are going up and then they are going down. So probably this is not a very safe time to hold on to long positions. If people are holding to long positions, one may be careful and keep an eye on the respective stocks, but not come out. Finally, we trade the particular instruments chart where we are holding the position. So if that particular stock is showing strength, we have no reason to exit prematurely, but we keep an eye on that and keep the trailing stop in place. That was study of all the graphs from sector and industry analysis. Now let us move to the sector and industry ranking information. Okay, the sector and industry information is available from the home menu and clicking on sector and industry. We classify the 10 broad sectors across multiple time periods spanning last 5 days to last 6 months. Rank them from 1 to 10 in each of these periods, 1 being the best performing sector, 10 being the worst performing sector for that period, and apply the heat map from cyan to magenta. It helps us see at a glance instantly which sector is strong in current period, like healthcare. It also helps us see how the sector is transitioning. If you are following, you remember that healthcare was weak for several time periods, but now we see it is gaining strength. So this is the way to catch the bottom of a sector or industry group and stocks in them for long-term investment. In this way, we see that healthcare is showing steady improvement in terms of strength. And all the others, if you notice, there is no clear pattern. It is magenta for utilities, then cyan, magenta, and cyan again. For industrial, color cyan, magenta, magenta, and then cyan. All the sectors, if you see, other than healthcare, is not showing any steady pattern. This is what is also contributing to the flip-flop, and it is clear from the industries and sector graphs plus this sector ranking table that there is no clear conviction on any particular sector, though the broad markets are going up. That is not a very healthy sign for a bull market. Now the analysis that we do for sectors, we do it for industries at a much deeper level, covering 160 industry groups. And you can see a lot of flip-flop here as well. Aluminium, for example, was strong for a long time, weakened very much a few weeks ago, and now it jumped back to the second ranking industry group. Biotech is showing sign of strength. It is in line with the strength shown in the healthcare as a sector. We saw that several oil related industries are doing well, and we can see integrated oil and gas here. It was weak for quite a long time. It is showing sign of strength across last 5 days and 10 days. So if you are energy trader or energy related stock traders, you will notice that sometimes integrated oil and gas companies, sometimes, it is not conclusive, sometimes they may move before the commodity itself. One hypothesis could be because the big oil companies like ExxonMobil, etc., they would know whether oil price is going to move up before other traders, before even other large traders come to know. ExxonMobil is world's largest publicly listed oil and gas company. Overall, the largest company in integrated oil and gas is actually the Saudi company Aramco, but that is not listed yet. Among the listed companies, ExxonMobil is the largest one. So probably they would come to know before anybody else. That is a hypothesis. Again, finally, if we are looking for a stock like ExxonMobil for taking a buy position, we have to look at that particular stock through Q charts and see if there is a valid trade setup. However, we can always use the broad market sector and industry analysis for a top-down approach and take long position only if the industry is showing sign of strength. In that case, we align more and more edges in our trade's favor, and over a larger number of trades, we have more consistent profit than it possible from pure technical trading alone. And that is the superior profit way of trading, combining technical analysis from Q system with broad market sector and industry analysis. To have a more consistent profitable result over a longer period of time. So we could, or you could look at some stocks in integrated oil and gas and see if there is a swing trade opportunity. And if you are day trading and there is no swing trade opportunity, you might consider taking a day trade in one or few such companies. If we go to the bottom, then we can see renewable energy equipment that I was mentioning earlier. It was worst ranking for long period of time. You can see on the right hand side, right hand columns, showed some sign of strength, actually a very big jump, upward jump in ranking. But we can just look at the color coding. We are visual traders in superior profit. So we can just look at color code and react to the information. We can see there was a sudden jump from magenta to cyan and again here over the last 1 month period. But then it declined again. The same is true for electronic office equipment. It was poor for a long time, tried to turn into cyan and turn back to one of the worst ranking groups again. And the third one that we watched in the graph was farming and fishing, which was again weak performer for a long time, tried to turn cyan and turn back into magenta again. So the flip-flop of market movers is visible from many different angles, from sector level, from the ranking table, as well as from the sector and industry graphs. So now we went through few of the usual markets that we look at technically. We looked at the sector, industry graph and broad market outlook through internals, looked at the ranking table, and now it is time to move to the postings in the traders community. There were several good posts from Binoy. We had nice discussion. If you haven't gone through that, you may go through that. But before I go through some of Binoy's posts, let me explain some trade that I shared in Trade Ideas. Usually I don't share day trades because it is too fast the time it takes to post a trade. By that time, probably the entry opportunity will be gone because I need to capture the screen, make a comment, mark the chart and post it. But I noticed this stock few days ago, LMT, Lockheed Martin. It is one of the strong companies in defense sector. And everybody reads in the news that the new US government is going to increase defense spending. So non-Q traders, average retail traders, may be tempted to buy LMT now. However, that is not superior profit way. If we look at the daily chart here on the left hand side, as of the time I posted it, for a long period of time since December 2016 till now March, it hasn't been able to go above the watermark level that was made in December 2016. It came down with a gap, moved sideways, tried to recover and hit the watermark level. At the same time, the bearish green signal came up and it is showing up as magenta color, so we know it is at pendulum high. However, I compared the chart with the checklist for headwind trade setup and there was no valid trade setup for swing trade. So I thought that it could be a possible day trade. And this is the concept that I shared earlier. If you see that there is no valid swing trade and you are okay to take a day trade, then you may look for a very low risk entry opportunity if you have that. So at end of day, I had run Sonar Q Explorer to find potential trades. I looked at LMT, all the checklist conditions for headwind were not met, so I was not ready to take a swing trade. However, I expected LMT to go down a little bit at least because of the resistance from the high watermark level and because the bearish headwind signal had come and the prices above the upper boundary. So next day, the market opened, not with a gap up, but a sizable up move from last day's close. It didn't open above last day's high, which is the green line. And now on the right hand side, I'm looking at 5 minute Q fine tune template that is used for day trading or for precision entry of swing trading. However, again, in this case, there was no swing trade setup. So I would not like to take a swing trade. So I was looking for a day trade. Market opened with a sizable move up, and then the early range was formed. The cyan dot is starting to appear. That is the early range high on the upper side, early range low. And in the post, I suggested that following our early range breakout rule, if price goes below this early range low, then we could take a short trade as day trade, put stop loss above early range high, just above 270, and book profit as per superior profit guideline, either once one of the support lines are met, probably this early range low of the day before, or once the risk distance is covered. And I posted it just as soon as the early range creation was completed. That is the cyan dot at the top and cyan dot here at the bottom of early range came up. And in a way, I was happy that I was looking for a short day trade and LMT opened up. So there is a slightly higher likelihood that it will retrace back at least some distance, enough distance for a successful day trade. The distance is not at all enough for a swing trade, but day traders are happy with shorter distances. So I was looking for that trade. That was the trade that I posted. And later on, see what happened on that day. Remember, that was the Wednesday. This is a chart of SPY. We saw earlier SPY QQQ DIA all opened with a huge gap up. And this is a chart of SPY, S&P 500 with daily chart hop on template. It opened with a gap up and constantly went up. It never pulled back. However, on the same day, based on the headwind and watermark level in daily chart, I proposed the short trade, and the short day trade worked out pretty well. The entry point would be in this yellow candle. When price went below early range low, the stop will be just at early range high, just few ticks above that. And one would have booked profit once the risk distance is covered, and put a stop to make sure that the entire trade is risk-free from that point onward. Where to put the break-even stop depends on how much profit is booked. If we book profit on two-thirds of position at this point, we can leave the stop at the original level and still have a guaranteed risk-free trade. However, if we book half profit, then we have to move the stop to the entry price. In my experience, both for swing trading and for day trading, it works better to exit two-thirds of the position at the initial profit target and leave the stop at the original stop loss, because the break-even stop loss will often be tested. That is how the market works. Once people realize that a down move is underway and enters a short trade, like in this case, market will go down. If we follow the Q charts, usually it goes down, but it will again come back to test that entry point, to shake out weak hands. As Q traders, we manage risk first. So in this case, the risk was small, but we also manage profit. So we'll book profit quickly. If we book two-third position profit, then one-third we could leave it at original stop and don't worry about it. We may put a order that exit the whole trade just before market close. The more advanced trading platforms like TradeStation, Thinkorswim, etc., they allow us to place a trade like that, that put a stop at 270 something. If that price is hit, exit my last one-third position, or with an or condition, or exit the position, the remaining one third anyway, just before market close with a market order. So those orders are possible in TradeStation or Thinkorswim or any other advanced trading platforms. So such a order could be placed, and we could forget about this trade once we book two third profit as a day trader and move on to the next day trade. It is important for a day trader to quickly book a profit on one of his or her trade, put stop on remaining position, and probably look for other opportunities if he or she has time. By the way, day trading whole day doesn't work well. So I'm not suggesting that, but if this trade was exited quickly, for example, here at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, New York time, and the trader wanted to trade for a while more, then he could look for another trade after initial profit was booked. So this shows that if we are following the signals properly, if we are alert, then even on a very strong up day, we could profit from a short day trade. Now, when I posted the LMT and then followed up, I noticed the SPY was going up strongly. So I had opened up the SPY chart using fine tune, and I didn't trade that. But after the fact, I shared the chart on SPY fine tune 5-minute chart and showed that there was a very profitable gap day trade in SPY. What is gap day trade? Gap day trade is one when the instrument opens with a gap up or down. So in this case, SPY opened at this price level. This is again 5-minute fine tune chart using real-time data on MetaStock. So this is the opening price on that day, that was Wednesday. It was well above previous day's low. This green price, this was previous day's low. It was well above previous day's low, well above previous day's high. So it's a very large gap up day. Then the early ranges were formed. Early range itself was narrow enough. So when price broke out of early range, then we are allowed to take a gap long day trade, which stopped just below early range low and initial profit target. Once the risk distance is covered, that would have happened at this pause line. So half profit or two third is actually my preferred way. Two third profit could be booked with stop left at the original stop and instructing the broker platform that exit the remaining half at the end of day anyway. So that would be a very profitable gap day trade on SPY. And the same thing happened in QQQ and DIA as well. And again, this is a very disciplined way of trading. I always think and share with traders that if you keep a trading diary, that is extremely useful. One of the ways could be to log the trade into the Superior Profit Traders community. You may maintain your own Excel. We have an Excel format that we share with traders, but the snapshots, etc., need to be logged also, and the community works quite well. And if you see the chart that Binoy shared, it is very crisp. It is very easy to read. And that is also a sign of a mature trader. When a mature trader looks at technical charts, he or she would like the chart to convey the information instantly, especially Q charts where we don't even use label of the indicators, just color coding. I see sometimes people share charts where the weekly, for example, is cramped or daily is cramped. That doesn't convey the information to trader instantly, but I like Binoy's charts, very crisp. And I myself post charts that are pretty crisp as well. So this was the day when Binoy shared the trade. This is a very large company in India, Reliance Industries. It is related to oil, a very large industrial company. In the weekly chart, it came down little bit and came back right at a support memory level. The support memory, resistance memories work almost like a magic. So we are always conscious about where it is relative to support resistance memory. And it was holding the support. It is a bullish candle, backdrop color cyan. And in the daily chart, it came down after the bearish headwind. After the bearish headwind, in terms of daily chart, it couldn't go up anymore, came down, hit the memory support. At the right edge, it tilted up again. So this is a very nicely taken go with flow long trade where the stop loss will be just below the support memory. And the initial profit target will be the upper boundary level, which also happens to be the resistance memory level. Very well presented chart and well analyzed chart for go with flow long trade. And Binoy had followed it up with result. He disciplined way, in a very disciplined way, book profit at his initial profit target. That is also a sign of mature trader. A newbie, a new trader wants to make a lot of money sometimes from one trade. So when it is going up, he is happy or she is happy, and there may be news media saying it is going to go up or whatever reason, they don't book profit. However, swing trades tend to have a welcome period. And we know it will be the, on majority of cases, the upper boundary or the resistance memory or watermark level, those are the optimal initial profit booking points. We may not want to book the entire profit, but at least exit enough position to make the entire trade risk-free. And Binoy did exactly that, very well executed trade. And later on, it went up further, so he could have a larger profit on the remaining position. Now, in superior profit way, we are disciplined traders. So we are not going to look at this huge long bullish candle with extreme high activity and think that it would be better to hold on to the position in a similar trade next time. That is not true. For a swing trade or for any trade for that matter, day trade or long term, we have to plan the trade at the time of entry. Where is the entry point? Where is the stop loss? And where is the exit point? And we must book profit. We must manage profit. Therefore, we must book profit at the initial profit point, at least partially, and then hold on to the remaining position. This is an extremely well-executed trade. And thanks, Binoy, for sharing it while he was trading it. Probably we have time for looking at one more trade. Mostly they are in recent times posted by Binoy. But instead of doing that, let me ask if you have any stock that you would like us all to look at. I don't have any trade idea right now other than keeping an eye on ORIG. ORIG. Tech. Okay, John, please use the Q&A panel. Not sure if you can see that. TECK. Okay, let's look at that. From John Yu. I would like to have the sessions more and more interactive. And thanks John for sharing one ticker. Let's look at tech. Now I have a list of stocks that I regularly watch. Again, that is the superior profit suggested way. Another list I create on ad hoc basis from sector and industry analysis. But tech is not in any of them. So first thing I do, I like to know what the company is doing. I don't trade only based on fundamental information, but I always like to know what the company is about. And Tech Resources Limited, I am now sharing my Zenith screen. So Tech is a NYSE listed company. Is a resources company based in Canada, engaged in exploring, acquiring, developing, producing natural resources. Steel, coal, copper, etc. So this is a basic materials company. I think John will know better. I'm just reading it now. It looks like a basic material company in steel, coal, copper, zinc, etc. So let's just quickly go to the industry ranking and sector ranking and see where basic material and coal or steel, where are they in terms of sector and industry ranking. So we'll go to our sector and industry page. And if we see basic materials as a sector, you can see it is not strong as a sector. It is flip-flopping. It was strong in the past, turned magenta, turned cyan, now magenta again, almost at the very bottom. 9 out of 10 in last 5 days and 10 out of 10 sectors in last 10 days period. So let's look at coal and steel. Coal as an industry group, you can see, is at the bottom, is very bottom and remaining weak for a long time. By the way, earlier coal used to be one of the best performer for a long time. That is the value of using the sector industry analysis. We could catch the almost the very bottom of coal related companies, book huge profit, probably go short, and now may wait for another opportunity. But right now it is all dark magenta for coal. Let me look at steel, because this company also has business in steel segment. Iron and steel is flip-flopping, you can see. The flip-flop, by the way, is apparent from many different angles, different industry groups, but it is showing signs of strength. So if this business, this company take, is having significant revenue from steel and not from coal, then one might look for a swing trade. That way we are not just using technical information. And if we just look at Q chart and take the trade, then we are just using Q system, just technical information, which may also be good, but I prefer to use the sector industry also. I don't know how much revenue comes from iron and steel. You can look up in Zenith or other sources, but for now, let's go to the Q charts. Okay. So I like to ask questions also sometimes. So those attending, especially those having Q system, and maybe even those without Q system, you know the color coding by now probably. Red magenta color is bearish, green cyan is bullish. So my question is, do we have a Q swing trade setup on this chart? Please type your answer in the Q&A box. Do we have a Q swing trade setup in this stock? By the way, if you want to look at the checklist, you can go to our website. Let's go to sitemap. From about, you can go to sitemap if you don't remember the link. In sitemap, there is swing trading at the bottom. If you click there, you will go to the slide deck, which includes the checklist for all the 4 trade setups. We have only 4 trade setups, one for each of the market conditions that we use, trending, sideways, exhausting, and reversing. So when we look at a Q chart, we would like to see if any of the checklists are met, and the checklists are unambiguous. So whether a person is looking at it from USA, Hong Kong, Japan, Indonesia, India, doesn't matter. And I see some reply that there is no trade setup. That is right. It takes only few seconds, maybe 10 seconds. Maybe for a beginner, 1 minute, but usually it takes 10 seconds or so to say there is a trade setup or not. So there is no trade setup. However, as Binoy also mentioned, there is a bounce trade possibility. It could be bounce or it could be sideways box trade. Now, box and bounce trade have different requirements. Right now, the requirements are not met yet. Now it has come to support, let me use annotation. It has come to the low watermark level. It has shown exhaustion. It has also shown a bullish headwind signal. And on Friday, it closed with a bullish shape candle. The color is still neutral, but it is a bullish shape candle. On weekly, it has come to a bottom, not exactly a watermark level. By the way, watermark levels are the smart swing highs and lows. Not every swing high and low will be marked as watermark. So we see there is no watermark in weekly, but it came to the last recent low. The candle itself in weekly chart is very indecisive. The relative performance is down, underperforming the market, and that is clear, because in daily chart also it came down, whereas SPY was going up, so relative performance is down. But for swing trade, as Binoy rightly mentioned, on Monday if it goes up, one might look for a very low risk entry opportunity. And one way I would do it, as I suggested earlier, and also as I traded the LMT, one might enter a trade on Monday if it goes above early range high using real-time chart, putting stop just below early range low. We would not like to hold on to the trade overnight as a swing trade if it doesn't show profit, right? So let me use the whiteboard. So this is at a low area showing signs of exertion, it may go up, at least on the daily chart. So on Monday, once the market opens, this stock will form early range high and early range low. So one way would be to take a very low risk entry and enter the long trade on the first 5 minute bar that closes above early range high and put stop just below early range low. And as Q traders, we take this early range breakout trade only if the distance between early range high and early range low is narrow enough relative to its daily range. That we can look up in the fine-tuned chart itself. So if this range is narrow, the early range is narrow, then it is possible to take a long trade if it breaks out of early range high. Now at the end of the day, it goes up and makes good profit. One can always book partial position, say 2/3, and hold on to the 1/3 position overnight. That is possible. However, if it is going back down, then I strongly suggest to cut loss, exit at pre-planned stop level, and not hold on to it thinking it will go back up, because there is no checklist condition for any of the swing trades is met. That is my view on this company. But a good pick, why I say good pick, you see this is similar somewhat to the way I was looking at Orange. I was patiently waiting for the stock to come down to a price level which has support and then go back up. This is a good way to track. I will not enter a swing trade yet, but there could be a potential day trade long opportunity that could be held on at least partially if the stock went up. Good ticker. I think there is another one, ANGI. Again, this is not a company I track. So let me quickly go to Zenith and see what the company does. By the way, this is exactly what I do in my own trading. I am not going to look at earnings, or I check earnings rate actually. If it is just before earnings, I will not look like to trade it. But other than that, I am not looking for EPS, revenue, all that data. Oh, it's Angie's List. Okay. NGI is Angie's List. I'm just opening it up with Zenith. It showed me the name when I typed the symbol, so I know it is Angie's List. It operates at National Local Services, Consumer Review Service and Marketplace. It's a kind of a forum for people to share information with each other, US-based company. Now, if we look at the snapshot on the right-hand side, it shows in last 1 year, so let me change it to 1 year, it is down 35%. You can see my screen, right? Okay, thank you. Thank you. Yanis, Mr. Yanis. So it is down significantly, whereas SPY strongly went up. So it is underperforming the market by almost 55%. Now in my experience, I have seen many traders who bought it at a higher price and still holding, never a superior profit way. Even in the line chart, we can see it was starting to go down, and around this level, I'm sure there was go with flow short opportunities. Around this level, there was go with flow short opportunities as well. But let us look at the Q chart now. There is no double bottom, triple bottom, but let's look at Q chart to see if there is any long trade opportunities. I assume that Mauricio, I think Mauricio, you know, I may not be able to spell all the names correctly. Apology for that, Mauricio. I'm assuming that we are looking for a long trade. Most people are not comfortable taking a short position, but if you are considering it for a short position, please specify it. Let's look at it from a long angle for now. ng.o. I will go to Q charts now. Some of the calculations we use, they need more data. For example, the memory trend lines may come from few days back to few years back. So if it is the stock doesn't have so old data, then sometimes a pop-up message comes in MetaStock. I just ignore the message, keep the indicator in chart, and don't repeat the message. Then we get this Angie's list. Again, the usual questions: do we have any standard Q trade setup? You can look at the Q at a glance chart. On the left hand side is the backdrop template. I hope you can see my screen. And right hand side is the daily template. Is there any standard Q trade setup? Let's see how many seconds or minutes you need. No, yes. Yes, very good, very good. Mauricio also said no, very good, thank you. And there are multiple resistance memory lines, so we are not going to take any long position. There is no watermark level at the weekly level, and daily level also too bearish. So if we are looking to buy, we will wait for it to break the memory, but we are not breakout traders, so we will need to, let me annotate again. If we are looking for a long entry, we will need it to break above the memory line. But by that time, the stop loss will be very far. We are not going to enter it. We are patient trader, and I'm happy to see also this is a trade where it went down a lot. So looking for a long-term long opportunity is not bad, but we would like it to go up, break the memory, come down, and just tilt up. Put stop just below that low, that new low that will happen, and that will be an optimal go with flow long entry opportunity. But right now, as you rightly noted, there is no trade. And now sometimes, you know, it's always good to see two stocks side by side. So we saw TECK and we saw ANGI. We concluded there is no valid Q trade in any of them. But if we ask ourselves that if we still had to trade, never we are suggesting we'll trade here, other than, as I said, maybe a day trade in TECK. But just looking at side by side between TECK and ANGI, they are in different industries, known. But as, ignoring all that, just technically looking at the two charts, which one you would trade if you had to take a long position, ANGI or TECK? Please type your answer in Q&A. If you had to take a long position, will you take it in TECK or ANGI? Just based on technical Q charts. Yes, TECK. Yes, though there is no trade setup, so we are not saying there is a trade setup, but just to understand that when we look at two charts, two stocks, we can easily know which one is stronger. and that is very useful in our trading. For example, the Reliance trade that was shared by Binoy, and I explained it today. When Binoy shared Reliance, he also shared another company called PLNG. And I had commented at that time, between the two of them, Reliance was looking stronger. It's a different thing which one made profit or not. We are disciplined traders. We just use the information we have. In fact, Reliance had a much bigger profit. But that is what we like to do. If we have two stocks in same industry, especially in same industry, we like to see which one is stronger. If we are taking a long position and like to take the stronger one for long and weaker one for short. So that was also a good discussion on NGI. I think we will end today. I don't see any other ticker idea. Thanks again for making it interactive. And to the Graduates Club members, I will encourage strongly, you are attending the classes regularly, you are posting the trades in Graduates Club, but do reply to each other so that I am not the only person. The more you interact, the more you will learn and more you will be disciplined. Trust me on that. The more you interact, the more you will be disciplined. That is very much needed in trading. I see some traders are doing pretty well, but sometimes taking trades that not so disciplined, though overall they're doing very well. So I hope we'll get more discipline, each of us, including myself. Thanks a lot again for joining. Please register for the next class in advance. And I always look forward to meeting you and see you same time next week. Have a great weekend.